Hello, today I'm just going to introduce you to the next era. We're going to be looking at Era 3, and we're looking at about 1000 BCE to 300 CE, give or take a couple hundred years. And we'll be looking a lot at the expanding networks of exchange and encounter, so I'll introduce kind of our two big topics for this era. We'll be looking at population growth and expanding networks of exchange. We've learned a little bit about population growth so far, but in this era, it continues to grow. Between 1000 BCE and 1 CE, the world population rose from about 120 to 250 million. So it doubled, more than doubled in those 1000 years. The rise was fueled by an acceleration in the rate of growth during this time. So population continued to grow, but it grew faster than ever. Between 3000 and 1000 BCE, you see here, it took about 1600 years for world population to double. But between 1000 and 1 CE, the doubling time was less than 1,000 years. The world population doubled much faster. And there are also some consequent, or let's look at some of the reasons that population growth really accelerated. The invention of iron was a big cause. Farming and pastoral nomadism continued to grow. There were improved species of crops that produced more food per acre than ever before. Horses and camels started to be used for work. And people lived in denser populations. We'll look more in this era at each of those details. And there are also consequences of this huge growth. The world population growing much quicker caused some things to happen. Some of the things that happened were deforestation. Forests were being removed. Societies became even more complex. In the last era, we saw that complex societies grew, but now they're getting even more complex. And collective learning increased, so the amount of knowledge that people were able to share grew as well. And more people began living in large cities, so more of the population of the earth was shifted toward living in large cities because there were even more large cities now. And the other part of what we're going to really be looking at is expanding networks. And a network of exchange is a web of connections through which people, goods, and ideas circulate. We learned a bit about this. The exchange of ideas and goods and people, or the movement of those in geography last year. So, like telephones or the internet, and even highways that cars drive on, are all networks of exchange. And we'll see some pretty neat examples of those networks growing. Here's a map of Roman roads in 14 CE, and those are part of the early networks of exchange. So, with extending networks, we see empires start to show up. Empire is a state that unites many territories and diverse peoples under one ruler or government. So lots of different people living under one government. In this era, we see a lot of empires show up. Empire builders had to move troops and supplies and dispatch messages, gather intelligence, and collect taxes. And this required good systems of communication and transport by both land and sea. So these systems were created mainly to serve the empire's government and army, but they also served as highways of commerce and exchange, cultural exchange, migration. So the empires built these so that they could run their empire, but the people were able to use them to trade and to kind of share ideas and also move. And here are some just examples of what we'll be looking at, but there are quite a few large empires throughout Africa, Eurasia, Africa, Europe, and Asia. So, to recap, we will be looking at in this next era, we'll really be focusing on the population growth, the reasons and the consequences, and also the expanding networks of change and how empires help contribute to that. Back to the old software here.